toy. The wrist on that boy, rock star like Pink Floyd. Waving at rude boy, I'm waving at you, boy. Ran off on the two like true goy. Imagine me, dude, boy. You could never do what I do, boy. Still ducking that I did, boy. In Paris for a hit, boy. These ain't the same type of hits, boy. Can get, boy. You don't take these type of risks, boy. Cause this boy been throwing that like rich, boy. You miss, boy. Your numbers don't add up on the. That was 10 years ago. If you know, you know. Yeah. If you know, you know. If you know, you know. This thing of ours, oh, this thing of ours. A fraternity of.
Oh.
And on the ground they go with the running back. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 15 yards on that one, and the Jets move the chains.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. It's Sylvester Williams there to bring him down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with 3rd and 5.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into.
Play fake here on first down. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Quadre Diggs. And the return comes to a halt right at the. The Jets making their way out last year in the impressive 3-2 start. A lot of people predicted they would go 0-16, but then after that start, they sort of collapsed, just two wins after week five. So as we look ahead to this year, Charles, what can we expect from the Jets?
Well, I would expect them to continue to play with great effort because their head coach Todd Bowles demands that. But Sam Darnold, their number one draft choice, he will be the key to their season. The faster that he plays well, the better the Jets obviously are going to be. And on defense, last in the league in pass rush last year, last in the league in sacks. They'll have to do that by committee this year and find ways to get pressure on the quarterback.
Here's Darnold now on second down, and the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there in good defensive position, able to affect the play.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. New York set to take the field. They were forced to punt last time, and I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would end up punting starting with this type of field position. Neither do they. Great starting spot, great opportunity to run your full playbook. They want to take a shot here, they can go ahead and do it. Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
Now they try the right side here. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. The tackle made there by Jared Davis.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Got an open man. It's a noon one. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth. This offense trots back out there now, and as they do, Charles, one thing to point out that we saw a second ago are some of the new rules in the NFL this year regarding kickoffs.
Yeah, nowadays, the kickoff team, no more running starts. Remember that when you kind of circle a guy around, and here he goes? No more. You have to start, close to the ball. And when it's kicked, then you get to take off and go, so you can't build up your speed that way. Also, when you're returning it, remember those wedges that we used to say where guys would form together, two or three guys? No more of those. So it'd be a lot more man-on-man, one-on-one blocking. And also, they have rules about where people have to be when the ball's kicked, where they have to be when the ball's caught. So to me, it's much more like a punt return than it is an actual kickoff return. So I'm eager to see if teams now take their punt returners, those nifty guys who make people miss in the open field, and make them the kickoff returners as well, because I think you can still get big plays in this area if you have the right people back there.
And a good burst there gets him seven up to midfield.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well. He's making quite a splash here in his NFL debut.
Well, he was advertised as being NFL ready, and both you and I tend to arch an eyebrow a little bit when we first hear that. But I think that they were right about this one.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We'll come back to Ford Field after this. And time to remind you that coming up at halftime, we're off to see the coach, Jonathan Coachman, in Orlando. He'll have a look back at a wild opening weekend in the NFL.
It's good to have Coach along for the ride this year, although he would probably say it's good for him to have.
That there, the first NFL touchdown pass for Sam Darnold. So retract the yardage and retract the touchdown.
And retract the chunk play. Big strike there to get the touchdown. Now they've got to take it back and see if they've got another one still in their arsenal.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. And they'll try the air now with Darnold. It's complete to Brown, right side. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way. Lost yardage.
No, for some reason, it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized, executed well, and you caused a lost yardage play. That's going to feel...
They'll run it now out of the gun.
No, Jack Patrick.
So we reach half. All right, we will. And they'll go on the ground. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Credit the tackle to Darius Slay. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made. And that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. To throw is Darnold. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
Sometimes it seems like a tough world out there. Many thought Sam Darnold would go number one overall to the Browns. And he fell to number three to the New York Jets. Ike fell to a great situation. He gets to go to New York with a rebuilding team, take over the job right then and there. And while many were expecting Broadway Baker Mayfield, instead they got sudden Sam Darnold. And I think the Jets fans are going to be very happy to have him.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down.
Well, he didn't make headway on that one, but he's had plenty of carries all night long. I just wonder if maybe he's a little bit tired from toting the rock that much.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down.
Something to watch here in week one of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus, the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
Darnold now to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left side. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Glover Quinn. And a big turnover there. The Jets offensive unit ready to get going here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
The interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
On second down, Darnold, and that'll be incomplete.
Just work with me a second here, because in my lifetime, seeing how quarterback percentages have changed in throwing the football, I mean, back in the good old days, if you were around 50%, you were doing okay. But now, you need to be 65 to 70% to be considered an elite quarterback. And in this ball game, I feel like we're playing old school, right around 50%.
Yeah, he's under 50%. He needs to start hitting more targets. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. And partner, this first week, this first game that we get to call together, so special every year, week one. You had the flyover, the big American flag out there before the game, all the hoopla, just having football back, so special.
It is an opening day, opening game. There's just nothing like it because you really build to a crescendo.